There's a part of the brain called the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus is like a little mini factory, and it is a place that assembles certain chemicals that match certain emotions that we experience. Those particular chemicals are called peptides. They're small chain amino acid sequences. The body's basically a carbon unit that makes about 20 different amino acids all together to formulate its physical structure. In the hypothalamus, we take small chain proteins called peptides and we assemble them into certain neuropeptides or neurohormones that match the emotional states that we experience on a daily basis. So there's chemicals for anger, and there's chemicals for sadness, and there's chemicals for victimization. There's chemicals for lust. There's a chemical that matches every emotional state that we experience. And the mind knows now that the hypothalamus makes neuropeptides, and those neuropeptides are strong chemicals.
Well, here's the story of the peptide in the cell. The peptides find the receptors and dock onto them, and stay attached, then they come off, and then they can come back on again. And while they're there, they are changing the cell.
A receptor that has a peptide sitting in it sets off a whole cascade of biochemical events, some of which changes the nucleus of the cell.
Each cell is definitely alive, and each cell has a consciousness, particularly if we define consciousness as the point of view of an observer. There is always the perspective of the cell. The cell knows where it is, the cell knows where it's going, the cell knows what proteins it's making, the cell knows whether it's about to divide or whether it's in a program to stop dividing. In fact, the cell is the smallest unit of consciousness in the body.
I'm hungry!
The cells are yelling up to the brain saying, we haven't gotten our fix today, and it's going to start sending impressions to the brain, and the brain is going to start to formulate imagery. It's going to sound like voices in our head.
I'm hungry.
To think of a reason why we should be depressed.
I'm hungry.
Think of a reason why we should be confused. Think of a reason for our own suffering. And the body is going to be telling the brain that it's not getting its chemical need. Chemical needs met. And so the brain will then activate and start going to our past situations and flashing pictures to our frontal lobe.
Oh yeah! We've commandeered an entire serving planet! Yeah!
Yeah! Keep it coming!
Yeah. Oh yeah!
Well, my definition of an addiction is something really simple. Something that you can't stop. We bring to ourselves situations that will fulfill the biochemical craving of the cells of our body by creating situations that meet our chemical need. So my definition really means that if you can't control your emotional state, you must be addicted to it.